Hello, everybody. My name is Ray. Welcome to the Evangelical Dark Web. Today, we're going to get hyped for God's Not Dead 5, Rise Up. We're going to talk about why this movie could be good, but probably and most certainly will not be good. Most Christians are probably unaware that there are 4 God's Not Dead movies currently. This week, PureFlix announced that there will be a 5th God's Not Dead movie to come out in 2023 called God's Not Dead, Rise Up. This is in a massive effort to boost PureFlix's streaming service by providing original content. So the premise of the movie, and let's actually look at the press release that PureFlix put out. Here's what we can expect from God's Not Dead, Rise Up. When a favored incumbent suddenly suspends his candidacy for Congress, an embittered but brilliant campaign strategist is lured out of retirement and convinces Reverend Dave Hill to run for office. The race pits them both against formidable opponents from their past, each with plans to inexorably remove religion's influence on public policy. Set against a backdrop of unprecedented political, civil, and spiritual unrest, Dave struggles to answer an increasingly relevant question in our time. Is God dead in American politics? David A.R. White, Dean Cain, Isaiah Washington, Ray Wise, Corey Oliver, and Brad Heller are set to reprise their roles in the new God's Not Dead Rise Up, which will film later this year in South Carolina. Harold Cronk, who directed the original God's Not Dead and the sequel God's Not Dead 2, will direct God's Not Dead Rise Up. That is a pretty bad sign, by the way, because God's Not Dead 2, I did a review on that, is the worst legal drama I have ever seen. God's Not Dead 1 is basically Big Eva promotion. So it begs the question of what Big Eva figures will be promoted in this movie. Are they going to bring in Justin Gibboni? Are they going to bring in the Ann campaign? I'm curious as to who they're going to bring in as a special guest cameo for this. Russell Moore? That would be the day. So what I counted is 6 characters are going to be reprising their roles. This begs the question of how many plots this movie will have. This movie has had over 4 plots in basically the first 2 movies. I haven't seen 3 or 4. Additionally, the focus is on Pastor Dave, who's one of the least interesting characters in God's Not Dead. He's one of the least interesting characters. In the second movie, he's practically useless as far as the plot goes. But here is the potential of this movie. The story resembles the plight of Sean Foyt, who launched an unsuccessful bid for Congress in 2020 after facing persecution in the form of lockdowns. Now, Sean Foyt, obviously a questionable character, but I'm just using him as an example because he's a high-profile example and there's precedent for this in real life. In a post-lockdown environment, the question I have is whether God's Not Dead is willing to go there or not. So that's the question. Are they willing to go there? Or are they going to sanitize what the actual environment of our country is like? These are questions that I have. So political dramas like Mr. Smith Goes to Washington, which came out in 1939, or comedies like The Campaign, which came out in 2012, are not insurmountable stories to compete with. And it seems like Reverend Dave's character is going to fit the mold of Mr. Smith. He is a Mr. Smith type of character. Recreating Mr. Smith Goes to Washington to fit the modern times would be the safest bet for creating a good movie. The reality is, the success of God's Not Dead 1 did not lead to improvement in God's Not Dead 2. God's Not Dead 2 is, again, the worst legal drama I have ever seen. Check out my review on that at Evangelical Dark Web, the channel, so subscribe. In every way, this story, despite being ahead of its time with its premise, had an exceedingly poor delivery. Does this same style of execution by the same director spell doom for Rise Up to be a good movie? Probably. But let the record show that the potential exists as previously explored. and just to explore it again. This movie will have an opponent who wants to kill God in politics while running, presumably in Arkansas. The second movie took place in Arkansas. I think the first movie took place in Arkansas, but I could be wrong. It could have been Louisiana. They should really have a consistent location for where this movie takes place. Just saying. But the franchise takes place in a red state. And most congressional races are not competitive. So this race, this movie should focus on a primary election, not a general election. So, but again, is this movie willing to go there? I highly doubt they're willing to go there with lockdowns, jab mandates, and Joe Biden's vindictive attitude. It is seems highly unlikely that they will delve into partisan politics that dictate the environments for elections. You know, most political movies name the political parties of the characters. Is this movie willing to do that? Again, this franchise will take place in a red state, presumably in a red district. So I ask, I believe this movie should focus on a primary race. And this is actually a much better premise if you want the message of the movie to be Christians should be involved in politics. If you want the message of the movie to be Christians should be involved in politics, write the story about a primary election, not a general election. Because primary elections matter more than general elections. Newsflash. Because determining the candidate in that goes to the general election basically determines how winnable the race is. Most of the time when it's competitive. So this movie should create, and this is how you write a good movie based on this premise. They had a good premise. I think they have a good premise for this movie. Here's how you make it a good movie. The movie should create a Mr. Smith runs for office storyline, which explores the willingness of a Christian to take actions necessary or questionable to win in politics. This movie should be asking the audience, in the face of liberalism, Christ or chaos. This movie should feature a villain who is a Republican politician or aspiring politician who wants to negotiate with the other side, Neville Chamberlain style, who believes that we should not be legislating morality and does not know what time it is. That should be the villain of the movie. A David French type. A Dan Crenshaw type. Someone like that should be the villain of the movie. Not a rabid atheist that we have already answered in the question of whether God is dead 4 times prior. Rabid atheists make terrible villains in a movie, not because they're unrealistic, but because they're one-dimensional. One-dimensional people exist. But if you want to make a good movie, the villain should be at least two-dimensional. So there's your premise for a two-dimensional story. Mr. Smith runs for office. Despite political naivete, he has a veteran political strategist in his corner, helping him navigate the moral dilemmas and moral issues that Christians face when running for office. I have experience running for office. I have experience answering ethical questions about whether to go negative or whether to go personal even. And what exactly is a red line that you cannot cross? I have experience doing this. That should be what this movie explores. And then it should ask the audience, because let's face it, liberals aren't going to watch this movie, or Democrats, I should say, aren't going to watch this movie. So just make it about Republicans and ask the question, Christ or chaos? That's your movie. So PureFlix, if you are watching this video, hire me to save this movie from sucking. But let's be real. let's be real, PureFlix is marketed towards women, specifically a feminine audience that wants safe content over provocative storytelling. So I did this video because, again, I like Christian movies, or I want Christian movies to be good. I am passionate about storytelling. And I'm also showing you I can make a better story than most Christian movies can. I just gave you a better story. Because, again, you're not reinventing the wheel here. Mr. Smith Goes to Washington was done in 1939. You're not reinventing the wheel. Reverend Dave is already a Mr. Smith. Use that character, fit that mold, go with that story. It's been nearly 80 years, so it's not old, or it's been over 80 years, so it's not like you're plagiarizing something that hasn't been done. It's not like you're Ed Littening a story here, or even rebooting it. But there's your movie, PureFlix. I challenge you to make that movie. I want to see feminist heads explode when you make that movie. Have a blessed day. Let me know what you think about my prospects, or my pitch, my story pitch for PureFlix. And have like the video, subscribe to the channel, and have a blessed day. I will catch you on the next one.